Now I'm going to show you how to install a WordPress theme, and we're going to use a specific theme for this website we're building. And essentially what a theme is it's what controls the overall structure of your website, the header, and that's going to be your area with a logo and a menu, and then your footer, and that's where you typically have some links and maybe a copyright and things of that nature. It's also where you can set some global fonts and some global colors, and it's also what facilitates fancy mobile menus when you're looking at your website on a mobile device. It's essentially the overall style of your website. So if I go to appearance and then click on themes, we're going to see the themes that are by default installed by WordPress. And these are actually made by WordPress. And what's interesting is they're so different. So this was the style in 2016. This was the style that they thought was really good for 2015. And here is 2017. So you can see kind of the evolution of how these look. And it's the same pages and posts and content. It's just the theme can make it look like this, like this, or even like this. Now, we're not going to use any of these themes. In fact, we're going to use a theme called GeneratePress, and it is the most amazing theme. It is lightweight. It works with any page builder. It is very powerful, and it has an amazing developer that's backing it. So what I'm going to do is click on this Add New button right here, and it's going to take us to this index of themes that are available for free for WordPress, and you can actually search themes right here and you can scroll up and down. However, for this project that we're working on, we have to use GeneratePress. So I'm going to go ahead right here and search for it. Well, actually here, let's do something fun. I'm going to go ahead and click on popular, and just to show you, it's one of the most popular themes that there are. So I'm going to just scroll down, and I know we're going to spot it here any second. And I'm scrolling, and there are thousands of themes here in the WordPress repository, and here it is. So I already know I want it. I'm going to go ahead and click on install, and it looks like it's installed now. So I'm going to go ahead and click on activate, and here it is. So now it's the active theme. So if I went to the front end of my website, and then I clicked on this little refresh button here in my web browser, you can see the style and look is totally changed to this, and this is all controlled by GeneratePress. So now what we could do is let's delete these themes that we're not using. And what we do to delete a theme is click on theme details, and then on the bottom right there's this delete button, and then we get this confirmation box right here, and then it deletes it for us. So I'm going to go ahead and delete all three of these, and you can see how fast they end up getting deleted. Just like that. And now we just have this one theme right here that we're using, which is GeneratePress. Now what we're going to get to do is install this custom child theme that I had specially made for you to bring special learning management layouts that I think are fantastic to your website. And this is something I worked with the developer of GeneratePress to have made, and he was kind enough to help me with that. So what I need you to do is click on appearance and then click on themes, and we're going to click on this add new right here. And then we're, instead of finding it here, you're not going to find it. I need you to click on upload theme. Now, I'm going to bring over those files that I had you download and unzip earlier. They're all listed right here. And the first one is right there, and it says child theme. So what I need to have you do is double click, and here it is. It's a zip file that we need to upload. So I'm going to move this down a little bit like that. I'm going to drag and drop it right there. Or if you wanted, you could just click on choose file and find this particular file on your computer. So now that it's there, I'm going to go ahead and click on install now, and it essentially just uploads it. And then I'm going to click on activate, and here it is. Now, I actually might change this thumbnail image. Maybe I'll have a designer put a really cool looking one that might have some WP Crafter branding, but that's all right for now. We can just use this. So essentially what we do is we're having, this is our parent theme and this is our child theme. And you can't delete this now because this is dependent upon this. Just like a child is dependent upon their parent, they work together. So essentially, this is the core theme, and we can put all of our customizations right here. And the reason we do that is because this right here is going to get an update at some point. There's going to be all kinds of maybe new features or optimizations that get released for this. And so, and it's going to be automatically done through WordPress. If we had all our customizations in here, what do you think would happen when we did an update? It would wipe them all out. So we put all our customizations in here so that we can update here. And this is just a good best practice to make sure everything is update safe. So now we have a custom child theme that you can only get from me. And it has a lot of things in it that I'm going to show you that really are going to power this amazing website that you are building for yourself. So now we're going to go ahead and install some plugins that we're going to use to power this website and bring unique features to it. So plugins essentially just add features and functionality to your website. And this is really the main selling point of WordPress, is that there's over 50,000 plugins available that can essentially make your WordPress website do anything. And there's good ones and there's bad ones. And I only will use the best plugins and the most important plugins. So I have a list of them right here. And let's just install them now. And as I install each one, I'll try to give you a brief overview of why we're installing it and what that particular plugin is going to do and what it's going to bring to the table for you. So I'm going to go to plugins and then go to add new. Remember earlier we cleared out all of our plugins. So all we have to do is search for a plugin right here in the top right, and then we'll click on install and activate the plugins. So the first plugin is called Elementor. So you can see I entered in Elementor here on the top right, and here it is. And this is our page builder. This is how we're going to make these beautiful page layouts. Now, Elementor is free, and this is actually going to show us all free plugins. However, there's also a add-on, a pro version of Elementor, where it will add some features, and I'll show you in the website where I used the pro version. Essentially, I just used the pro version for the pricing table on the homepage, and I used the pro version for the countdown timer, but I'll walk you through all of that. It's definitely not necessary. So I'm going to go ahead and click on install now, and then it's going to download it, and then I'm going to go ahead and click on activate. Okay, there's activate, and we now have Elementor installed. So now I have to click on add new again, and this time we're going to choose a plugin that actually I'm a contributor on. It's called Full Width Page Templates. This is a plugin that I came up with in my head, and it allows any page builder to work with any WordPress theme. It is so easy to use. So I love it, and it's definitely the one plugin I use on all of my websites, and I highly recommend it. And of course, I am the contributor in that because it was my idea, and I put the people together to make this free plugin happen for you. So the next plugin that we're going to use is a SEO plugin, and it's going to allow us to put SEO information that Google wants to see when it comes to your website. And so it has a funny name, it's Yoast. So I'm going to click on add new, and it's actually one of the most popular plugins. I'm surprised it's not showing. Oh, there we go. I'll click on popular, and I'm sure it's going to be listed here as I scroll down. And wait, I am not actually seeing Yoast. Where is it? There it is, Yoast SEO. Over a million websites it's active on. So I'm going to go ahead and click on install now. And this is going to create a sitemap for Google. It's going to allow you to put those page titles in and information on each page and lesson that Google wants to see. I'm going to go ahead and click on activate. And that is a very important plugin to have on your websites to make sure it is definitely search friendly. So let's click on add new and get to our next one. And this is going to be called Nav Menu. And it's right here, Nav Menu Roles. Now, this is optional. You don't have to have it. Essentially, what this plugin allows you to do is when we have our menu for our website, you can have certain menu items visible depending on if someone's logged in or logged out. So what this is going to allow us to do is if someone comes to your website and is not logged in, you can have a button that says login. And then if they're logged in, you probably don't want them to see a button that says login. You now want them to see a button that says log out or no button at all. And so that's what this is going to allow us to do, this nav menu roles. So let's go ahead and install that one. It's just going to give us those options when we are building our menu system. The next one is going to be called Lifter LMS, and this is the learning management platform right here, and it's what's going to allow us to create courses and have them all linked together with the lessons and automate sending email notices to our students and all kinds of cool stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Activate. Now, this plugin's different. When you click on Activate, it takes you to this installer right here. So let's just go through it really quick. Let's click on Get Started Now. And essentially it's saying, do you want us to set up these pages? Yes, this is actually fine. Click on Save and Continue. Okay, now we want to choose for our payments where we are. So choose the country you are in. So for me, it would be United States. And then, of course, choose your currency, whatever your local currency is. And then check this box that says enable offline payments, but we're going to change that later. Click on Save and Continue. Now, right here, it's basically saying we want you to send us anonymous information on how you use Lifter LMS. I don't like sharing my information with anyone. I'm sorry. So I'm going to always go and click on No Thanks. And I suggest you click No Thanks as well. And then here's an option to install a sample course. Now, you can do this or you don't have to do this. It's up to you. In this video series, we're going to manually create a course. So it's entirely up to you. But for learning, you might as well want to click on here and install the sample course. But just keep in mind that you're going to need to delete it anyway because you don't want it listed when someone's on your website. But for initial learning to see how it's set up, you can click on install sample course. So I'm going to do that right now. So gone ahead and clicked on it. It might take a second because it's doing a lot in the background. It's creating a lot of information in the background. So now it takes me to all these new options that are here that Lifter LMS added and created. And one of them is this course section right here. And it's showing me the course right there. So anyways, now we have Lifter LMS. We're going to go through this in detail. So let's leave that now and finish installing our plugins. So I'm going to go to Plugins, Add New again. Now we're going to install one of the plugins that was in the resource file. So go ahead and click on Upload Plugin. And here is all those folders that was in the download. Go ahead and click on Plugins and then go right here and drag and drop that there. And then click on Install Now. What this is the payment gateway for PayPal and your Lifter LMS installation. It's going to allow you to take PayPal payments. Now, Lifter LMS is a commercial solution. They have all these commercial extensions that add features to it, and they have other payment gateway options and things like that. This extension right here is normally $99. If you went to their website, you'd pay $99 and you would get updates for it and support for it for a year. But I'm including it in this resource package. And the reason I'm doing it is this notice right here. You can double click on that and read it. It's essentially saying that Lifter LMS is GPL licensed. And I don't want to get into like a lot of legal terms, but you can read it. Essentially, the way it's licensed and the way most WordPress plugins and themes are licensed, you have every right to give it to someone. You can resell it to someone. You can redistribute it. Now, when you're buying a plugin or a theme for WordPress with your money, if it's GPL licensed, you are paying for updates and support. And so when you do buy any of these paid extensions, you're paying for updates and support for it. So you're not getting any updates or support for it, but if you wanted that, you can head on over to their website and purchase this, and they'll give you a license code that will get you automatic updates for PayPal. If you're just starting out with your course and you're obviously not making any money from it yet, I suggest that you use this, start building your course, try to get some sales, and as soon as you start making some money from your courses. You might want to invest in a license so that you can get updates and support to this payment gateway for Lifter LMS, and that money also goes to support the developer of Lifter LMS. Okay, so next I'm going to go ahead and click on Add New, and we're going to install a plugin that makes it easy to send. We're going to install a plugin for emailing. By default, WordPress will email out, but because it's not through a proper method of emailing out, they tend to end up in the spam box, and there's a real simple solution for it. So just go ahead and search for SMTP, and there's a bunch of SMTP plugins, but we want this one down here that's widely used. It's called Easy SMTP, and it's right here. You can see it's already on 100,000 websites, and we see a lot of SMTP plugins here. But one of the things I like to do when I'm deciding to try a plugin is I want one that is being used, because if it's being used and it's active on a lot of sites and it has good reviews, then there's a good chance that it's going to be supported and it's going to work well for you. So there's two options here, and I've used both. I've used Easy WP SMTP, and I've also used WP Mail SMTP. So this plugin is obviously the one that has a larger user base of 600,000 active installs. So I'm going to go with that one, and I'm going to go ahead and click on Install Now. Now we're going to configure this. This is when we set up that email account. We're going to plug in those email address informations into that plugin so that when WordPress sends an email out, it's going to go the proper way. Now, lastly is a backup plugin, and let's just go ahead and click on Add New, and we're going to search for Updrafts. Okay, this is an optional plugin. You do need a backup solution. You don't want to rely on your web host ever. You always want your own backup solution, and this is a backup solution where it will back it up to Dropbox for you, and there's some other backup locations it can send your backup to. I use this on all of my sites, and it's a real good best practice to always install it when you're first setting up your website, because if you say, I'll probably do it later, it's easy to forget later, and you never end up having that backup. It's just a great insurance policy, and it's completely free, and it's super reliable. They do have some paid extensions that you can purchase if you wanted. I actually have the paid version. It adds some additional features that I like to have, but the free version is perfect. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and activate that, but we're not going to configure that one till later. So now you can see we have a few plugins installed. Now, if you see any of my videos, a lot of times I'm doing a video on a particular topic, and we're just essentially adding a plugin to a website to bring some functionality. So there's so many different plugins you may or may not want to have on your site. Just keep in mind, you don't want to just be adding plugins. You definitely want to have plugins that you know are going to be reliable and they're well coded, they're not going to slow down your site, and you know that they bring a feature that you really need. So that's it for the plugins that we need to continue moving forward with this amazing course website that you're building.